Okay, and welcome back to video 2 of the Linux from Scratch video tutorials covering 6.5 of the Linux from Scratch book. In this video tutorial, I'm going to be covering the preface chapter of the book. Okay, so you want to get to the book, Linux from Scratch, follow this link right here on the website. Click on Read Online, Stable LFS, and click on the forward. Basically, what is covered in the forward is Gerard Beekman's story about creating LFS. It's a pretty good story. Section 2 is the audience, and what basically goes over here is the main reasons for why you should choose Linux from Scratch. Basically, the main reason is for educational reasons. Prerequisites. Basically, you should know how to navigate within a shell, and you should know how to copy and paste files. Basic file manipulation and moving throughout a Unix system. Section 4 is host system requirements. It's basically a section that covers all the software that you need on your development platform. And it talks about how the Linux from Scratch system is going to be a 32-bit system. Make sure that all these packages are available on the development platform so you can build a Linux from Scratch system. Section 5 is typography. This covers all the text formatting that goes on throughout the book. All right, the next section, Section 6, is the structure of the book. Basically, the book is divided into three parts. Part 1 being the introduction, Part 2 preparing for the build, and Part 3 building the LFS system. And Part 7 is the errata. Currently 6.5 has no errata information that needs to be applied to following the procedures in the book. Alright, so moving on to Chapter 1. Chapter 1 covers 5 basic topics, and I'm going to go over them. Alright, so Section 1.1, how to build an LFS system, basically tells you you need the live CD, which you've already downloaded, and it's the starting point for the development of an LFS system, and it also provides you with the information from Chapter 2 to Chapter 9. It gives you a little nutshell information on what each chapter goes over. Section 1.2 covers all the software that's been updated since the previous iteration of the book. Section 1.3 covers all the changes that have gone on since the previous iteration of the book. It goes all the way down. The previous version was 6.4. Section 1.4 covers the resources that you can go to find information about LFS. FAQ is definitely very helpful. Mailing list and IRC is always helpful as well. And Section 1.5 talks about asking for help and kind of following a series of procedures to get help about the book when you do need help about the book. Just to kind of discuss things to mention right here, getting help with the configure script and help over compilation issues. All right, time for Chapter 2, Section 2 of the book, preparing for the build. Chapter 2 starts off with preparing a new partition. Basically, there are 4 steps in Chapter 2. The introduction, creating a new partition, creating a file system on the partition, and mounting the partition. Basically tells you right here what's going to go on in Chapter 2. These are the steps creating the new partition. There's 2 programs you can choose, a CF disk or F disk, to create a new partition. Section 2.3, creating a file system on the partition. It talks about how extended file system 2 was the most predominant file system, but as Hard drives became bigger and support for journaling came about. EXT3 replaced EXT2, and the file system that we'll be creating for our partition that we create is EXT3. Lists right here the code required to make the file system. Section 2.4, mounting the new partition. After you've created the partition and then you've created the file system for it, you can then begin to mount the partition. Alright, so the next step is to open up VirtualBox. Our VirtualBox has just finished opening. This is the main window for VirtualBox. This is the system that I created earlier in the tutorial. I'm going to go down here to the CD-ROM, CD/DVD-ROM. Click on the CD-ROM, DVD-ROM tab. Click Mount. Choose ISO image file. Click the button to the right. Click the Add button at the top. Scroll down to wherever you saved the live CD.ISO file. This is what you're going to want to select. Select. Click OK. Click the Start button. Alright, this message basically tells me that if I press the left command key on my keyboard, that it will switch the focus of the mouse and the keyboard back to the native macOS operating system, and then I can hover the mouse over the virtual machine, click on it, and it will, all mouse input and keyboard input will be taken into the virtual machine, so I don't need to see this message anymore. I just clicked the F1 key to see the list of boot options that the Linux LFS live CD gave me. I'm just going to go with the default options. So basically, when I clicked the F1 key, it gave me a list of available kernels, and apparently this is the kernel I have available. So I'm going to click Enter. It's going to load the kernel. And it's going to begin to load the host development platform required for building the Linux from scratch system. We'll select the time zone that where I'm located over to GMT. The system clock is set to local time. Choose the default. Scroll down through these options, use the up and down arrow keys, click the tab key to go to the next element and click return or enter. Press enter, and the host system has finished booting. I'm going to begin section 2.2, creating the primary partition for the LFS system. I'm going to be using the program called cfdisk to create the primary partition. So this program is cfdisk is telling me I have 2,132 megabytes available. If you look right above it, it tells you the size in megabytes. So I'm going to create a new partition. I use my arrow keys to scroll through the options here. Create a new. Primary. I will use all the make it bootable. And I will write the partition. It's asking me, am I sure? Yes, I am sure. Type in yes. Write the partition table to disk. Alright, it's time to quit the program.